Today, we're going to start with our pick a pocket task 2. We've already completed task 1. So let's review what we're looking at today. So who can tell me what the manufacturer is asking us to do?
I wanted them to be able to take those measures of central tendency and apply them to actual real life data. So they had to be able to find the mean, median, mode, and range of the data that they collected from the last week. Then they had to take their mean and their median and apply that to a new data set that they had to make up.
Okay, so we're gonna use that data to kind of help us justify the decisions that are gonna be made by this company. All right, so on your paper, you have a table here. So you're gonna have to get out your data. So you have 5 seconds to get your data out of your folders. Five seconds to get your data out of your folders. 4, if you don't have your data, share with a friend. We're going to create a table with your data. We're gonna create a table and then we need to find within your table, you're gonna do the mean, median, mode, and range.
On my research for the standards, like specifically what the standards were asking for, I did have to go to outside resources. So I use Bite Out of the Core, I think is what it's called, but online resources.
Okay, I'm gonna give you 5 to 10 minutes. I'm gonna turn the timer on, and you're going to have to use your data to find the mean, median, mode, and range, the measures of central tendency of your data.
I want to know that they know what the mean is, they know the meaning of that number, and how can they use that. So in that, my conversations, that's how I'm assessing students that way. And then in the end, once they created their own, because that's what they've done on their own, creating their own data that matches, then I can look to see, once they're showing their work, does it match, does it make sense?
Now, the second part of this assignment is gonna make you take things a step further. It's almost like a challenge situation. All right, yeah, people are saying, yes, you rise to the occasion. All right, so now we have a situation where you see all these little boxes, okay? Your job is to create a second data table.
What?
That's different from the first. So we had our first data set, yes? Mm-hmm. Which was our students in our pockets. That was, yes. Now today, we're gonna make up data.
Make it up.
You can totally make it up. Here goes, I'm gonna give you some conditions on what you make up. Okay, because I don't want 3,467. All right, first thing is, in here there are 12 boxes. How many boxes are there?
12.
12 boxes. Your data set, the number of numbers that you need, is going to be bigger than 8, so 8 or larger, or 12 or less. Can I have 9 numbers?
Yes.
Yes. Can I have 8 numbers?
Yes.
Yes. Can I have 11 numbers?
Yes.
Can I have 12 numbers?
Yes.
Can I have 7 numbers?
No.
No. Can I have 13 numbers?
No.
No. So you can have 8 to 12 numbers. Okay? You can pick any numbers that you'd like.
Yeah.
However,
yes.
Here comes the curveball. They have to have the same mean and the same median as your data from our class.
Now that I'm the facilitator and not necessarily the sage on the stage, I can allow the kids to take the class where it needs to go. So, but that takes a lot of of letting go as a teacher. We're so used to that control and results, you know, I need them right now. And sometimes that, you know, that path doesn't go where you want it to go. So I find that our most meaningful lessons and the way that they learn the most is me not standing in front of the classroom. And that's what these kinds of performance tasks and RCD has allowed me to do, is not stand in front of the class, you know, giving them information, but allowing them to find the information themselves. And it makes it so much more meaningful for them because they remember it because they found it, it's theirs.
Tell me how you got this. I'm very curious about that one.
So I did all of these.
Okay.
But then I kept getting different answers.
Okay. So what is this one?
That's 32 divided by 127.
So in whose case, whose data is this?
Mine.
Is it your data?
His is 4, but...
Okay, so even if it was even, so if even if it was 4 plus 4 is 8 divided by 2?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. So this is where you made your mistake, huh? Because this would be 136, so it's not 4. You got to figure out the right number there. So how many groups of 34 are in 120?
They were able to do it, and that was pleasantly surprising. I think they were able to do it, though, because they are comfortable with mean, median, mode, and range. If they weren't comfortable with that, I don't think they would have had as much success as they did. There were still some, huh? And what are you talking about? But not as much as I anticipated.
Perfect, good. Okay, so now we save this number, circle it, so we're using it for your data. All right, clap once.